today's world. I think that it's everywhere. I think quite commonly the kids will probably know TikTok, where you can literally become a viral sensation overnight. So I think media's thoroughly changed and it's in every job now. Every single company in the world looks for PR. They look for someone that knows how to use social media, because everyone is very well aware that it can blow up your whole business. Just even schools, every school's got a Twitter now because they need it. Media lessons, we will obviously do times where we have to look at what we're watching, but there'll be a lot of, quite similar to English actually, analysis of what's happening in the scene, which is, this is quite a good course for students who do literature or language, because they can also pick out just different elements of the scene. There's always going to be a chunk of the lesson that is towards written work, but there is also a lot of times where we will be watching stuff and it is quite nice to analyse them and talk about it. A lot of group work as well, because you need to break things down together and get other people's interpretations as well. At the moment, I think media is very important because we teach it from year eight. The reason we do is we've always had the thorough belief in the English department that when you are learning about media, you're learning not to trust everything that's put in front of your eyes. You're learning about bias, misinformation, and really it's teaching you to be a better person as well, that you should go out in the world and do your own research. And that's also what we're trying to do in media, open up pupils' eyes to see that there's a whole world out there, and just because someone says something or you've read one article, it doesn't necessarily mean it's true at all. Picking media would probably link with obviously media in university, but also, like I said, PR, public relations, film studies, English, and filmmaking as well. I think A-level age groups are a whole different ball game to Key Stage 3 and Key Stage 4, because these students you can have a lot more of a personal relationship with. You can be a little bit more of an adult yourself with them because they understand it a lot more. I also think that A-level students have a whole different level of humour that they can go into. I find that as well, I don't think it personally makes a difference on whether you're a younger or older teacher, but I do think I get along with the students quite well because I'm quite up to date on what the trends are. Like if last night there was a song trending on TikTok, we'll start talking about it, or I'll be humming it and they'll go, I know what you're humming. So I do think that it's quite easy to bond with them. Plus, it's easier to get them back on track. So if we are having a little moment where we go off topic with the older kids, you're like, right, back to the lesson. Whereas with the younger kids, you've really lost them for a minute.